Hey everybody, what's up? It's Andrew here with the next installment of our e-bike review series where we pitted 10 of the best e-bikes in North America head-to-head against each other. Today we're going to be talking about the bike that won the best descending out of the whole group, and that is the Trance E Plus SX0 Pro. This bike is an aluminum frame. It has a 160mm Fox 36 factory front fork and a 140mm Fox DHX2 coil rear shock with the Giant Maestro suspension. It's not a new design, but it's a proven design that they have used on everything from their XC bikes to their World Cup winning downhill bikes, and it performs quite well. For power on this bike, we have a Yamaha sync drive motor with a 500 watt hour battery. This is actually our first time using the Shimano sync drive motor. I'll talk a little bit about that later, but it was definitely interesting to get on that motor for the first time. As for geo, the important numbers are a 66.5 degree head tube angle, 460mm reach on a size large, and 470 chainstays. The seat tube is 74 degrees. We'll have all the rest of the geo on the website. That's kind of the most, you know, important information to start out this review. But we have a full written review of this bike on the site as well. And then retail price, this is the top of the line bike that retails at $7,000. Giant also has a bunch of, you know, more budget friendly builds of this bike, but you retain the same geo, same basic idea. So let's talk a little bit more about this bike. So this is a bike that we were really excited to get. It actually came in kind of late to the test, but at the same time, it absolutely destroyed. It was an amazing bike. Before this bike showed up, we were actually gonna give the best descending title to the 180mm rear travel high bike Enduro Xduro, which would make sense since it was the longest travel bike in the group. It has an amazing rear suspension design, and it's a heavy bike that is just built to hard charge. However, this 140 bike came in and snatched that title away, which surprised a lot of the testers, but it's a really great complete package bike. It has a really nice build, and just all around the Maestro suspension performs quite well. And the coil rear shock obviously does just an amazing job of soaking up hits. This is a bike that was very well composed, even though it has somewhat shorter rear travel, in like just heinous, rocky, awful conditions. Giant bills this as their Enduro bike, and it definitely falls in that category. It's basically a downhill bike that you can also pedal the top with a motor. And we really enjoyed that on this bike. It's still plenty fun to ride as well. It's not quite as dead and sluggish as the high bike is. But at the same time, it wasn't nearly as lively as bikes like the Norco Site VLT or the Specialized Turbo Levo. So you do sacrifice a little bit of the playfulness on the bike in exchange for all our performance in rocks and technical situations and terrain. That said, the build on this bike is more than up to the task. This is one of the few bikes where we really were super happy with the build, even with Giant's in-house bars and wheels. The wheels on this bike held up to abuse much better than a lot of the other bikes. Specifically like the Scott, where I blew up the wheel one run in. This bike took weeks and weeks of me beating the crap out of it with zero damage to the wheels, zero damage to the bike, all in all, really impressive. So let's talk a little about the motor. So this is our first time on the Yamaha sync drive motor, like I said earlier. And it's a really cool design, but it's very pared down. So a lot of other bikes have fancy displays that show you all kinds of information and stuff. On this particular model, there is no display. It is just a controller on the bars with an up and down, a power on and off, and very minimal other, you know, controls aside from that. There's a series of LED lights that indicates charge as well as power settings when you press those up and down switches. And a bunch of our testers were frustrated by that. You know, they wanted to see speed, they wanted to see cadence, and more importantly, they wanted to see distance to empty on the battery life. There was no way to see how your power setting was really influencing the battery life in a visual display. You know, it wasn't a huge deal, but there definitely were testers that didn't like that. Giant does offer an app that you can use, so you can have the bike via Bluetooth sync with an app, and you can actually data log your rides, you can change a lot of stuff, and you can track all the information. So if you are someone that's interested in that, it may not be on the bar unless you want to mount your phone there, but it is available. I personally liked it since it kept the bars uncluttered, and you can actually flip the bike upside down to work on it without worrying about scratching the display. The motor itself was quite loud. Actually louder than the Bosch ones. I can't quantitatively say that since we didn't have a decibel meter out there, but it definitely just has a lower note, and it is a little bit more, I don't know. just captures your ears more. If that's something that's important to you, you'd probably want to look more towards the Brose mode. It's on the Specialized. That one was almost silent in comparison to the Shimano, Bosch, and Yamaha. Other than that, that pretty much rounds out our complaints about the motor. It has really great power delivery. The other problem we have with the Yamaha was that it was a weird software thing, but if you were sitting on the bike and had your foot resting on the pedal, it would try and lurch forward. We actually reached out to a Giant about that, and it is just something with the motor. It seems to me like that's a software fix that could happen, but regardless, all the Yamaha bikes seem to be doing that right now, so that is something to consider. Other than that though, that pretty much rounds out our complaints of this bike. We were all really happy with it. It was in the running for the best e-bike overall, but it just came a little bit short in terms of agility and maneuverability compared to the Norco Sight VLT and the Specialized Levo. But if you are someone that is looking to have a really well all-around bike that is capable of hard charging, capable of hitting technical rock hardens and large features, this is an exceptional bike. It also has a really nice integrated battery, a sleek look, sleek design, and a really great build spec. So it really is the complete package that I think so many bikes are trying to hit. So if you want more information, you can go to our website. I have a written review there where you can check that out. But for now, this is kind of our thoughts on this bike. So definitely one that we wish we could have kept longer. Super fun bike all around and just a really well thought out design. Check out the rest of these on the site or on our YouTube channel, and thanks so much for watching.